In the year of the dragon, in a world beyond the realms, I, like all the others, awaited the birth of the dragon of whom the prophecies foretold. But the Dark Master heard the prophecies as well. I should have hidden the eggs long before, but I thought we were ready. I thought they were safe. Oh, how I was wrong.
Save them! The Dark Armies have come!
May the ancestors look after you. May they look after us all. Eventually, the egg came to rest in a distant swamp, where a family of dragonflies gathered round, wondering what magnificent creature could possibly live inside. They didn't have to wonder for long. What emerged from the egg frightened them at first, but finally amazed and astonished them.
8, 9, 10. Here I come!
It was a purple dragon, who they eventually adopted and raised as one of their own. They named him Spyro, and he grew up alongside Sparks, the young dragonfly who was born the same day. In fact, the two were almost like brothers. And a more oddly matched yet compatible pair of brothers the world has never seen.
Never catch me this time, purple boy.
As for Spyro, he, like all of us, accepted the world into which he was born, believing he was one of them. A big purple one of them, true. But one of them, nonetheless.
I see you, my little glowing friend.
Seeing and catching are two different things, a big boy.
Yeah, you better run.
Mm-hmm.
the matter, little Spyro? You can't fly? Oh, that's right, you walk everywhere. That's too bad.
You're toast when I catch you!
Ah, must be tough to lose all the time. Ah!
All right, let me out of here, you overgrown fungus. Spyro, seriously, lend me a hand here, will you, brother?
Geez, Sparks, I don't know. Frogweed's gotta eat, too.
Spyro, whack it! Do something! I'm your buddy! My wings are getting moldy!
Ugh, now I smell almost as bad as you do. And that's pretty bad. See you later, sucker!
So much for gratitude. Hey, that's cheating. We're not allowed in there.
Excuses. Catch up or give up, Chunky.
Where's that little gnat gone now?
Have you seen a giant purple thing around here? I seem to have lost mine. You know, this is getting a little boring.
Sparks!
I thought all you guys was gone.
Invisible coward, let me go!
No, don't let him get away!
Pathetic wretch!
I've had about enough of you!
Sparks, look out!
No! Was that fire, dude?
Take care of him! I gotta report to Sender!
Get me out of here, Spyro. I think my wings are singed.
You okay?
You almost torched me, dude. Wait. You breathe fire! So I'm just about ready to blow the top off that place and kick that guy's booty when Spyro let loose with some serious flame, dude. No joke. Flames from the mouth.
Well, I was just trying to help.
No, some help. He nearly turned me to ashes, dude. Mom, Dad, you should have seen him. He came out breathing fire, all right? I tell you, it was crazy. You don't believe me? Spyro, tell him.
Well, it's true, Dad, I swear. I just got real mad, opened my mouth, and whoosh, Flame City.
It's not that, Spyro. I believe you both. It's just that your mother and I knew this day would come.
What day?
The day when we would have to tell you the truth.
So that was the night that Spyro learned he wasn't a dragonfly after all, but in fact an exile from an unknown distant land.
So, you mean I'm not your real son?
You are our real son. It's just that you came from somewhere else. Far away, where wars rage on, and the innocent seem to always pay the price.
It wasn't long after that night that Spyro decided to venture forth and find his home.
So that's it, huh? Leaving Sparks behind the old homestead? Not a care in the world. Don't look back.
This is your home, Sparks. But I just found out that my home is out there somewhere. And I've got to find it. Besides, I'm not leaving you behind. I'm just leaving you where you belong.
Well, I thought I belonged with you, because I'm always with you. But I guess I was wrong, huh? I'm sure. I'm wrong on a lot of things. You know what? You're right. I'm wrong.
Don't worry about him, Spyro. You know how hot-headed he can be. You'll see him when you get back. Now, son. Keep your head up. Your nose clean. And use that breath of yours wisely. All gifts come with a price.
Don't listen to your father's preaching, Spyro. Just be yourself. It's all any of us can do.
So, hard as it was, Spyro left the only family he had ever known and journeyed on to where he did not know.
Spyro, so me and the old man were chatting, and this whole belonging thing, you know, came up, and we decided that Best friends belong together. Even if one of them is purple and does have some weight issues.
Weight issues, huh? Well, at least I've never been turned into a lantern.
Oh, please, lantern schmantern. Let's see what's out there.
Thank you.
Breathe, Sparks, old boy. Go to your happy place.
What in the world was that?
I have no idea, but I'm going this way, far from it.
Which brings us to the moment that Spyro's journey really began. When he and I finally met again for the very first time. Oh, it's a long story.
And I thought you were a big one. Goodness.
You're alive. But it's too late. Too late.
Too late for what? Who are you? Do you know me? Where do I come from? What are you? What are we? What am I?
You mean you don't know?
Does it sound like he knows?
You're a dragon. When you were just an egg, it was my job to protect you. It was my job to protect all of you.
There are others?
Others? There were. There were four of us. Guardians, that is. And we had one job. Ensure that all the eggs were hatched. It was the year of the dragon after all. And our very survival depended on those eggs. But the temple and grotto are now gone. Overrun by...
Temple? What temple? Can you take me? Can I see it? Where I came from, I mean?
No. Who knows what forces occupy the temple now? What state it's in? You don't understand. After they came for you...
They? Well, who is they, and why did they come for me?
Because the prophecies spoke of a purple dragon. A dragon born only once every 10 generations. You.
You? Does that mean him? Wait, this guy, Spyro, some special once-in-a-purple thing? I think you might have mixed that one up. Whoa, that's a little... bit of a stretch. I've heard some doozies in my day, but that takes the cake.
Spyro, is it? Well, Spyro, I assure you that I'm telling you the truth. The Dark Army's attacked, intent on destroying the eggs and killing the rest of us. And they nearly succeeded. And then they lay siege to the other islands. We were at war. For many years, we fought all over the islands. Brutal clashes with the armies of the Dark Master, who was intent on preventing the prophecies from coming true. The other three Guardians and I led our small but valiant forces into battle after battle against our ruthless, mercenary foe. And when we were beginning to turn the tide, Cinder came.
Cinder?
Yes, Cinder. Cinder was... is... monstrous, horrific, ferocious. A black dragon that fills the skies with terror. An unstoppable force of nature.
Yeah, you had me at ferocious. Listen, sounds like that thing that was chasing us, Spyro.
Yes, she still searches for me. And years ago, I watched as Cinder plucked the other Guardians from the fields of battle, like so many ripe grapes from a vine. Without them, our cause is lost. Only I, Ignitus, managed to escape. Not that it matters. Cinder now rules all, and I sit here wondering what might have been, what else I might have done.
Wow. Sounds fun. I want to hang out with this guy.
Yeah, why have you given up? I just find out that I'm this special dragon, and you tell me all is lost? That I have no home or family left? I've come way too far to give up now. I want to see where I come from.
Hold up, Savior Boy. Were you not listening to this guy? He's talking about flying dragons and war and horrible... This is bad stuff, all right? I don't know if we're hearing the same thing.
Yes, Spyro. It's not as simple as that. It's true, the prophecies spoke of a purple dragon destined to put his stamp on this age. But the prophecies didn't foretell the devastation that surrounds us now.
Maybe you're right, but I'm willing to try. I want to take the first step.
You're actually gonna go along with this lunatic?
Very well then. We'll go. You deserve to see your beginning before it all ends.
Am I the only one sane here? He's telling us we're doomed, all right? That's when I go, maybe we should, go back to the forest with the flowers and the fun stuff.
Cinder's soldiers must have knocked the other two statues out of place. Heathens.
What other two statues?
On the other side of this door are two statues just like these. When all four statues are positioned correctly, the door opens.
Yeah, good. I was never good at geometry, so what do you want us to do?
Spyro, I need you to get in there and move the statues in place.
Me? How?
There's a small tunnel that animals use to access the caves. Find it and use it.
Yeah, animals are... Okay, you know what? You do that, and I'll wait here. That. Hey, when in doubt, break it, right? Go nuts.
Yeah.
Any trouble?
A little insect trouble. Nothing I couldn't handle.
Little insects? My tail section.
The past is prelude. Tomorrow a dim promise. Allow us entrance. Do not reject us.
Are you making that up?
It should open for us. There is a disturbance. It seems my fears have been realized. They've desecrated the interior as well. Yes, we'll have to open it the old-fashioned way. Make your way through the connecting rooms, restoring every statue you can find.
Hey, you know what? Let's don't and say we didn't. Why don't you do it?
You want my help? Very well. Hop up.
All right. The old guy's coming to life.
Careful, Spyro. Cinder's forces are surely on their way.
Oh, goody. Ooh, take a gander at this. Hey, Spyro, what was that about?
I don't really know. I just felt like I had to hit it. And when I did, the power of 1,000 suns surged through my body.
Right. Okay. Well, you know what? You should really sleep better. You know, I'm gonna stop bugging you. We really need to get 8 hours.
Forget I said anything. Let's go.
Quite an entrance, young dragon. There might be hope for us yet.
What are these things?
These are spirit gems. A gift from the ancestors.
What kind of gift?
A gift that speaks across generations. A gift that empowers you with the spirit of the past, strengthening you with the wisdom of the ages.
I feel more powerful already.
Exactly what I feared. Look, Spyro. Perhaps we should turn back.
What? After coming this far?
If this door is closed, it means there are intruders behind. It's how the temple protects itself.
Yeah, it doesn't work too well, does it?
So, what are you saying, Ignitus?
What I'm saying is the only way the door will open...
Don't say it.
...is if the intruders are kicked out of there.
Didn't I just say don't say it?
Thank you. Well, Ignitus, we nabbed your guardian buddies, but you managed to escape our clutches. Until now.
Stand back, Spyro. And let me show you what a dragon trained in the ancient ways can do.
Whoa, the big guy's got some moves.
Are you okay, Ignitus?
Yes. As I get older, it takes longer to recover.
You are incredible, Ignitus. Can you show me how to do that?
Patience, young dragon. Soon enough, you'll learn all I have to teach. But right now, you must fight. If Cinder's forces were here, there would certainly be more of them in the temple.
Oh, goody.
They won't be there for long.
Wonderful, now he's getting cocky.